to our fifth topic in our Learning Alliance on Land Tenure and Pastoralism. Our topic reached a critical issue of our exchange, and that is the relationship between land tenure and sustainability of pastoralist productive systems. We have been discussing for several weeks now the main characteristics of land tenure and pastoral communities in East Africa and in the Andean Altiplano. But now, what we would like to do is to assess the relationship and the implications of the different land tenure regimes and the sustainability of the pastoralist communities. Please have a look at our key materials, starting with Elliot Fratkin and Robin Mearns' paper published in Human Organization on a comparison of the lessons learned in the East African Maasai and Mongolia, where these authors present the conditions for the sustainability of pastoral production systems. A fantastic publication by IUCN, the Governance of Rangelands and the Assessment of Collective Action for the Sustainability of Pastoralism. Pedro Herrera, a member of our Learning Alliance, Jonathan Davis and Pablo Manzano are the editors of this book, and the chapter one written by these three authors is a great synthesis of the main issues underneath the relationship between different aspects of sustainability of pastoralist productive systems and, in particular, the land tenure regimes. Please go ahead and make your contributions following our key questions. First of all, although we have been already discussing the characteristics of land tenure regimes, please make a synthesis, make an effort to have a typology of the main land tenure regimes in the pastoral communities in your region or country. But most importantly, in second place, if you can share with us what are the different implications for different aspects of sustainability of these systems, in particular, livestock productivity, the maintenance of access rights to water and grazing lands, as well as political and economic stability. Please have in mind the main contribution of Ian Schoons in the 1990s regarding ecosystem management, in particular the ability to have this tracking of different aspects of their pasture systems in terms of herd mobility and the equilibrium between the number of animals and the availability of pastures. We all are looking forward for your contributions and reaching our last topics in the following weeks to complete our Learning Alliance. Thank you and see you in our Learning Alliance environment.